Today we are going to study about organs of speech. In the last class we had studied that we require an airstream and energy to produce the speech sounds, and most of the languages in this world are produced using pulmonic aggressive airstream mechanism. So today we are going to study organs of speech. This air that we breathe out through the that comes out of the lungs, there are many organs that are working into converting this air into the speech sounds. So we are going to study about such organs, and they are referred as organs of speech. So the main organs of speech are lungs and the vocal cords. In last class I had described to you vocal cords, how where it is situated and what is the function of it. Then tongue, teeth, lips. So usually if we look into, lungs are used for breathing, vocal cords are used for shutting the windpipe so that food won't enter while we are eating, and then tongue is used for differentiating taste, and teeth is used to bite or chew the food. But these are just the primary functions. These organs also involve in the production of speech sounds, and therefore they are referred to as organs of speech. There are all these organs of speech can be divided into three groups. First one is respiratory system, which comprises of lungs, muscles of the chest and windpipe. Phonatory system comprises of larynx, and articulatory system comprises of nose, teeth, tongue, roof of the mouth, lips, etc. So if we study the respiratory system, let us study this respiratory system. We already discussed about respiratory system, how the air that we breathe out is used for the production of speech sounds, and how lungs, the walls of the muscles of the chest and the windpipe and the walls of the lungs acts as the initiator for the pulmonic airstream mechanism. We studied all that. Phonatory system includes the larynx, and we know that two lip-like structures are there, vocal cords, based on whether it is closing or opening, that we know whether the sounds are voiced sounds or voiceless sounds. We will study all that in detail. So let us see voiceless sounds. So I told you that there are two vocal cords, and these vocal cords are like this. Let me show you. This vocal cords, when it is widely open, this is the glottis, the space. The space is so much, and when the air moves out, when the air moves into our outside, what happens? There is no vibration. It moves without any friction. So such kind of voice are known as voiceless sounds, like p, k, etc. Then what about voiced sounds? When these vocal cords are loosely held together, and when the air passes, there is a friction, there is a vibration. Okay, some friction is there, and such kind of voice which are produced are voiced sounds. So in the voiceless sounds, like when the vocal cords are open, widely open, the air passes without any friction, and the sound that's produced is referred to as a breath. And such kind of sounds are known as voiceless sounds or breath sounds. In the case of voiced sounds, when the vocal cords are loosely held together and the air passes and it vibrates, there is friction, there is vibration, then the sound that is produced is voice. And such kind of sounds are referred to as, the sound thus produced with the vibration of the vocal cords are referred to as voiced sounds. Example, b, d, etc. Next, let us study the articulatory system. Articulatory system comprises of the roof of the mouth, tongue and lips. Roof of the mouth. Let us study roof of the mouth. This is our teeth, and just behind the teeth, if you touch, there is a convex part where the root of the teeth is there, and that part is referred to as teeth ridge. Behind teeth ridge, if you touch inside, roof of the mouth is this part. If behind that teeth ridge, if you touch, it is a very hard concave area. Okay, and that particular area is referred to as hard palate, and behind that it is very fleshy soft palate, and behind that there is uvula, which we say tonsil, etc. Uvula. So the another name for teeth ridge is alveolar ridge or alveolum. Another name for soft palate is velam. So let us see the position of suppose this is the roof of the mouth. This is the back part of the teeth. It is like this. Roof of the mouth is like this. This is the back part of the teeth, and this is teeth ridge, and this is like convex. This is concave area, which is the hard palate. Behind it there is the fleshy area, soft palate, and behind that we have got this hanging like uvula. Okay, so I hope you understood that. Next, let us see. We studied all this. Now let us see how we can test whether a sound is voiced or voiceless. We studied about the vocal cords. When the vocal cords, when the glottis is wide open and when the air passes through and when there is no friction, we get voiceless sounds or breath sounds. And when the vocal cords are loosely held together and when the air passes through, there is the friction, vibration, and such voice are called voiced sounds. And there are two tests that in which you can find out whether a particular sound is voiced or voiceless. Let us take the example of p and b. P is voiceless and b is voiced. First test is keep your fingers on your throat, on your Adam's apple. Then you can feel the vibration when you talk. So just say p, b, b, b. You got the vibration. So that is voiced sound. Another test is close your ears with your palm and tell the voice. P, b, b. When there is buzzing sound, that is voiced sound. When there is no buzzing sound, it is voiceless sound. So we studied roof of the mouth, and I taught you this roof of the mouth. What are the different particles? So this convex part will be the end. Here is our teeth. The convex part just behind the teeth is what? The convex part which is there, that is teeth ridge or alveolar ridge or alveolum. The next is the concave part, that is the hard palate. Behind that there is the fleshy part which is soft palate. Okay, now let us imagine that this is our mouth or face, and here we have got the walls of the throat. Our mouth is coming. So here we have got the walls of the throat, and so our mouth is like this. Okay, so when this soft palate can either be raised or lowered. When the soft palate, you can imagine this, when the soft palate is raised, it touches the walls of the pharynx. So the air can only go out through the mouth. It cannot go through the nasal cavity. So actually, if we study the organs of speech, there are two cavities. One is oral cavity, our mouth. Another is nasal cavity, inside our nose. Okay. So when the walls of the pharynx is there, the throat is there, this soft palate can either touch it, like it can be raised like this, or it can be lowered. When it's raised like this, the air can pass only through the mouth, and the sounds thus produced are oral sounds, any sounds, any sounds. But when the soft palate is lowered, what happens? The air passes through the nasal cavity, and such sounds that are produced are known as nasal sounds. For example, m, n, ng. See, even my nose is moving. M, n, ng. P, b, t, it doesn't move. M, n, ng. See, so these are nasal sounds. There are another sounds as well, nasalized sounds, that when the soft palate is lowered, nasal passage is also open and oral passage is also not blocked. Such kind of sounds doesn't exist in English. It exists in Hindi, like aang, oon, and all it exists there in that particular words. Now let us see the tongue. Let us describe the tongue. The tongue, the tip is okay. Again, I am using, because I cannot show it, like I am showing like this. Suppose this is the tongue. Okay, this tip part is known as tip of the tongue, and this part is known as the blade of the tongue. Blade of the tongue is opposite to what? Teeth ridge. Teeth ridge, blade of the tongue. Then that part which is opposite to the hard palate is called front of the tongue, that part which is opposite to the soft palate is called back of the tongue, and the end part is the root of the tongue. I hope you understood that. The tip and the blade are together known as apex. Now, last thing that we are going to study today is active articulators and passive articulators. We know that there to the production of speech sounds. Even now you can see that my mouth is moving. These are all articulators. Tongue, mouth, all these are of articulatory system. So whenever we produce a sound, there are two articulators. One will be active. That one will be moving to the other. Another one will be passive. That one will be remaining stationary as such. Okay, so that particular articulator which moves to the other is known as active articulator, and that particular articulator which remains stationary are known as passive articulator. Mostly the lower lip and tongue are the active articulators, and upper lip, upper row of the teeth and roof of the mouth are passive articulators. I hope you understood all what we studied today. I'll just summarize it once again. So we studied that airstream mechanism is the energy that is required to produce the speech sounds, and most of the speech sounds are produced by pulmonic aggressive airstream mechanism. Then we studied that airstream mechanism is the energy that is required to produce the speech sounds, and the air that we breathe out of the lungs is what the organs of speech use that air to convert it into speech sounds. And the organs of speech like that are lungs, vocal cords, tongue, teeth, lips, etc. We divide it into three groups: respiratory system, which includes the lungs, muscles of the chest and windpipe; phonatory system, which includes larynx; and articulatory system comprises of the nose, teeth, tongue, roof of the mouth, lips, etc. Then we studied the respiratory system, how the all the what all are there in the lungs and how the air is breathed out, etc. Phonatory system, about our Adam's apple and how vocal cords are and how the vocal cords open and close, etc. We studied the vocal cords, the lip-like structures that are placed horizontally from front to the back. They are attached in the front and separated at the back. So it is based upon the vocal cords. Whether if the vocal cords are wide open, the glottis will be wide open. Glottis is the space between the vocal cords. The glottis will be wide open, and the air that passes through will not have any friction. And such kind of voice is referred to as breath. And such kind of sounds produced using this is with the vocal cords loosely held, like with the vocal cords wide open, are referred to as voiced sounds. And where the vocal cords are loosely held together and there is not enough space in the glottis, and the air produces, when the air produces, there are some vibrations, and such sounds are voiced sounds. We studied the technique, how we can find it. Then we studied articulatory system. We studied roof of the mouth, teeth ridge, hard palate, soft palate, uvula. We studied about the tongue, tip of the tongue, blade of the tongue, front opposite to hard palate, back of the tongue opposite to soft palate, and root of the mouth. Then we also studied oral sounds and nasal sounds. We studied that there are two cavities, one is oral cavity and one is the nasal cavity. And when the soft palate is, can both be raised and lowered. If it is raised and there is like, it is restricted, this is the wall of the pharynx. If it is raised, then the air passes only through the oral cavity and we have oral sounds. Any sounds in English, most of the sounds are oral sounds. Then when the soft palate is lowered, what happens? The air passes through the nasal cavity and we produce sounds like m, n, ng. There are nasalized sounds and that are not important for us. And then we studied what are active articulators and passive articulators. Active articulators are the ones that move to the other. Passive articulators are the ones that are stationary. Usually lower lip and tongue are the active articulators, and the upper lip, upper row of the teeth and roof of the mouth are the passive articulators. I hope you understood this session, and I will conclude with that one technique that we studied of finding out whether a particular voice is voiceless or voiced. Just keep your fingers on your throat and produce the sound b, p, b. So bird, there is vibration. So that's why it is voiced sounds. Another is close your ears with your palm and say bur, bur, bur. You got the buzzing sound. So these are some of the techniques that we can use. I hope you like this class. Thank you.